What are you? Get it open.
On it.
He's gonna show. He'll bring the whole goddamn place down.
Stay focused. We'll be out of here before anyone can stop us.
Oh, Christ.
Move in.
Stories, you know. Sent three home in an ambulance. The rest in body bags.
No wonder the cops want him dead.
Hey, you ever seen him?
Yeah, Gotham Zoo. With all the other flying animals.
Keep doing this.
I have to. No one else will.
Every drop of blood, everything you've sacrificed. The city is safer now. It's made you a target. And people will keep you in the crosshairs until you're shot out of the sky.
Criminals in this city. They need something to fear.
Shit!
The hell did he go?
Whatever got in, don't let it get out.
Thank you.
Back to back. Circle up!
I know you're trying to create a myth, but be careful you don't turn into a monster.
Sometimes you need a monster.
Come at! Come on! Come on!
Mother teach you to knock. Behind you, big boy. Huh? Heyday.
You're under arrest!
If you want to be intimidating, you're succeeding. Criminals are becoming afraid of you, so are the police.
It's a scare tactic, Al. Just a performance.
Without a scratch.
So far. That doesn't belong to you.
I was wondering if we'd cross paths.
You broke the law. Here I am.
Cut the shit. The law. Don't tell me that's why you do all this. Squeeze into a suit, tie on a cape. Most people dressed up like that end up in Arkham.
Gotham needs a hero. someone to hunt down people like you.
So that makes me, what, a villain? Sounds fun. Gotta admit it, though. You give a good chase. One day you might actually catch me.
Tonight.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal? It's dangerous.
Then let's put you in a cage.
Bring it, Bat.
It's over.
I wouldn't be so sure.
Two of them now? Jesus!
I got him!
Wait, wait, wait! Do not shoot!
Why go to all that trouble for this?
Shit!
A myth can't be killed. You, however, are flesh and blood.
God damn it!
I said don't shoot!
No! Wait!
I was wrong about you catching me. Not sure if it was for my sake or yours.
Give up! There's no way out!
Give me some credit. Bye, Bat.
Step out of the shadows and be Bruce Wayne tonight.
Oh, that's a much harder fight.
Don't let tombstones be your family legacy.
Well then. Time to save the city.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. A humble district attorney like myself is not used to such a ringing endorsement. Even one who cut Gotham's crime rate in half. For too long, this city has burned with corruption and greed under Mayor Hill's authority. But I promise you, a vote for Harvey Dent is a vote to finally put your foot down. And together, we can stamp out the fire and save our great city. If only Mr. Wayne, my campaign's largest backer, could have heard that applause, he would... Well, there he is. Fashionable and fashionably late, as always. Say hi, Bruce.
Welcome to Wayne Manor, everyone. My apologies for the late arrival.
Oh, not to worry, Mr. Wayne. We've all made ourselves very comfortable. Thank you. Thank you again, everyone, for your unwavering support. Together, we will change Gotham. Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Now, I know this is the biggest mansion in Gotham, but I don't think you got lost on your way here.
Where were you? I know you prefer the brooding billionaire angle, so the sooner we make nice with the donors, the sooner everyone will leave you alone.
Just wanted to make an entrance.
Congratulations, you almost missed it. You are a pillar of this city and my campaign. I need you here, tuxedoed and shaking hands. No one came here tonight to see me.
Some champagne.
They want to see the Bruce Wayne, am I right?
And I can see him just fine from here.
This shouldn't be painful. It's not a kidney stone. It's only a little FaceTime with potential donors. Your face, specifically, with a mouth that's saying, "Support Harvey Dent." We're the grease, they're the wheels. And they're rolling in enough cash and votes to help make Gotham a place for families again.
I'll do anything for Gotham. It's my home.
It's our home. This'll help you too, Bruce. Once I've turned this city around as mayor, you'll be a hero for funding my campaign. Now all I need is a decent slogan. I'm terrible at those. It always makes me sound like a used car salesman. Which, for the record, I have not been since before law school.
All right. How about, put a dent in crime,
Look at you. It's not half bad. I'm gonna use that.
Bruce, I meant what I said. Together, you and me, we change Gotham. A city free from crime, where children can play in the streets again.
That's what I want too, Harvey, but you know how rough it is out there. We have to shake things up to make that happen.
Well, we can start with a few hands, Come on. Mr. Wayne, I'd like to introduce you to...
Bob and Regina Zellerbach. Of course I know these two.
Hello, Bruce.
Regina here is the chairwoman of Wayne Enterprises, and her husband...
voted for Mayor Hill last time. I'll admit it, Mr. Wayne. I don't know Mr. Dent from a pothole on Main Street, but I trust your family. If you believe in Dent, we believe in you. After all, whoever you support is a reflection on you.
And we trust someone like you to lead this city to greatness.
Well, I'm flattered, truly, but this night is about getting Harvey Dent elected so he can fix those potholes.
I think I speak for half the room when I say politicians are puppets.
Oh, come on now, Bob. I'm not a politician. I'm a crusader. No strings attached.
Old families like ours should flock together, you know. Like birds.
You're preaching, dear.
No, it's true. The Waynes and Zellerbachs are reminders of the golden age of Gotham.
This city's luster faded years ago, Mr. Dent. Look at Gotham now. Murder in the streets, corruption in City Hall, that Cape Bat Freak dealing out vigilante justice like it's the wild goddamn West.
Oh, Bobby, regarding golden age, seems you're getting cranky in yours. There's always hope.
Forgive me for being blunt, but one man can't save this city. And it's a dangerous mentality to think so. That's how you get creeps like this Batman.
Well, I have to say I side with your wife on this, Mr. Zellerbach. Even a spark of hope can light the darkness.
Oh, an idealist with a bank account. He'll be broke before election day.
And I know Bruce would gladly spend every penny he has to fix this city. I don't doubt that for a moment. Don't worry, though. I am not doing this alone. And with Bruce's help, we're replacing the dangerously unsecure Arkham Asylum with a state-of-the-art mental health facility to help Gotham's most at-risk individuals. It will be dedicated to Thomas and Martha Wayne in the hopes that their fate will never be repeated.
After all your parents did for this city, to be killed in a botched robbery in some alleyway, it was terrible. Truly terrible.
And tragedy like that at such a young age must have been crippling.
If only that deranged man had gotten the right treatment, maybe... Well, I don't like to think about maybes. And I'm sure you don't either.
Well, Harvey is the one who's been behind the project since day one. A vote for him is a vote for the memory of my parents.
You'll have it.
Thank you. Thank you both. Not saying I doubted you, but that went better than expected.
It is a night of ringing endorsements.
Hello. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
This is a private fundraiser, Miss Vale. No reporters allowed.
Well, you don't mind if I stay and ask a few questions, do you, Mr. Wayne?
Well, you can ask me whatever you want at the press conference tomorrow.
Actually, I'm here for Mr. Wayne.
Tonight is strictly off the record. We can talk, but nothing gets written down.
I'm okay with that. I was just hoping to see what makes Bruce Wayne tick.
This is quite the social event, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, come on now. So formal. Call me Bruce.
Well, Bruce, you've been going around pleasing everyone tonight. But how are you doing? You should enjoy your own party before all the champagne runs out.
Well, I'm doing better now that you're here. I'll tell you, if all these stuffed shirts weren't around, I'd give you the private tour.
Mr. Wayne, you've got something on your collar. Is that blood? Yeah. It looks like...
Spilled some wine. It'll come out.
Stick to clear alcohols, Bruce. They never stain.
Do excuse me, Master Bruce, but another guest has arrived.
I'm sure they'll find the bar.
You may want to greet this one personally, sir.
Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Falcone's never been convicted of anything except being a businessman who loves this city. Excuse us, Miss Vale.
And what kind of business do you think he's in?
The one that controls enough votes to get me into City Hall. This is the necessary evil of politics, Bruce. It's in the service of a better Gotham, for all of us. Look, at least hear him out before you kick him out. Falcone requested to speak with you directly.
Jesus, Harvey, inviting a known criminal to your fundraiser doesn't exactly look good for your squeaky clean image.
Let me worry about that. A word of warning, Bruce? Play nice.
You know, I've been in the market for a new house. Decent walk-up, sky-high ceilings, plenty of room for my cars. I think I'll take it. Though the decor offends my eyes. Oh, man, all flash, no class.
Well, you couldn't afford it.
Yeah, right. Carmine Falcone, thank you for welcoming me into your home. You're a respectable man, I hear.
Gentlemen, perhaps we'll all be more comfortable in the parlor.
Follow me, if you will.
You should know, Mr. Falcone, my analysts say we're raising triple what Mayor Hill has... Hey, what's...
Private audience.
Oh, come on, guys. Bruce?
You'll be fine out there, Harvey. I saw plenty of skirts to keep you busy for a few minutes.
We talk alone. Just you and me. Sorry, Harvey.
Yeah, I'll get a drink or something. Christ!
Yeah, well, that's just like Harvey, huh? Wants to make sure the rules are followed. But in my experience, there's the law, and there's doing what's right. You understand? And I'd rather see Harvey actually help this city instead of just saying he will.
Well, I would say you can uphold the law and still do what's right.
To a point. No one gets remembered for staying in the middle. I ain't here to chinwag about politics, Mr. Wayne. Gives me indigestion. I got enough of that as is. So, let's talk relationship. Chalk this for me. Be a pal. I can get Harvey the mayor's seat. Or I can pull it out from under him. Whatever happened to being a gracious host? Okay, imagine. This is me. And these are all my friends in Gotham. The businesses, restaurants, clubs, docks, unions, politicians. I make them all move. And I want to keep everything moving if Harvey gets elected. That's why I came here tonight to your lovely home, hoping to make a new friend. One who can help Mr. Dent see the light, if need be. Between your businesses and mine, I bet we employ half the city.
Look, I'm only talking to you because Harvey asked, trusting a friend to know what's best for Gotham.
Now that's a predicament. You listen to me, kid. I know, somewhere inside that tuxedo, you understand this situation. Money gets money. The risks, the alliances, the hidden costs. Your father knew which hands to shake. And which to break.
Don't you dare talk about my father.
You're getting worked up over nothing. Hell, I knew him longer than you did. People don't say no to me. Not for long.
Master Bruce, your guests are leaving. I recommend seeing them out. You wouldn't want to be rude.
Heed your butler's advice, kid. Oh, and I'm no longer interested in buying the house. The owner's a prick. And he's gonna get what's coming to him.